Rocky Top Student Center on the campus of Quinnipiac University. I'm Jaymie Parker.
And I'm Billy Mecca. Today we're going to take a look at an emerging sport in college athletics called acrobatics and tumbling. This sport is gaining momentum throughout the country, and Quinnipiac has been a pioneer in its development.
Also, as you may have heard, Quinnipiac is building a medical school, and we're going to find out how it's going to affect both the university and the athletic programs.
But first, let's check in with a member of the men's basketball team who has overcome plenty of hardships and has excelled not only on the court, but off the court as well.
He just had a nice way about him, and he seemed like a good kid. And one of the things in the first meetings with Coach was, I want good kids, I want kids of character, I want kids that are going to fit into the community at Quinnipiac. And after spending 5 minutes with Justin, you knew that he was that type of kid.
When I first met him, he was such a shy kid. You had to pull the words out of him, and it was definitely tough.
There's definitely an evolution of Justin Ruddy. I think freshman year, when he came to Quinnipiac, he was very introverted, very shy.
He was a mute a whole freshman year. And it's awesome to see like his growth from a freshman to a senior now.
My freshman year, I was just like how you say, hanging on, trying to learn everything, trying to like feel my way through this college level basketball. So I was just, that's how like I feel like I interpret things, is by being quiet and like looking at everything, how everybody else is doing and stuff like that.
He's always been a good kid, and now he's a kid that he's a leader. He thinks before he acts, which took a while to get there. And his decisions are pretty good now.
He's the classic case, I think, of a kid who came to us as a teenager and is leaving a man, I think, in every way, shape, or form. And it makes everybody proud. It really makes Alyssa proud, and it makes myself and everybody on my coaching staff really proud to just have played a small role in his sort of stepping into adulthood.
As Justin matured, his performance on the court also took off to new heights.
His rebounding ability on the offensive boards is, I've never seen anything like it. There are probably one or two guys in the country every year that can rebound like he does.
I mean, yeah, when ruddy is ruddy, I mean, there's a lot of people afraid out there. I mean, the opponent, the coaching staff, we're afraid. I mean, he is dominant.
And that's something that I always try to play as, try to do as. Like, I really, like, every time I step on the court, I, like, think, like, I'm a beast, I gotta play like a beast. Everybody else gotta think that I'm a beast. So that's just the way I want everybody to look at me as a beast when I step on the court, especially on the court.
Because he went from being a good young player to being a great player in his sophomore year and stayed at that level. So it's been obviously a pleasure to coach him.
Justin realized quickly that success on the court went hand in hand with hard work in the classroom.
He stayed very humble. He's very respectful at all times. He's just a great guy, a dependable guy, but he knows what he wants and he works hard to get what he wants.
Justin's a kid that has always set goals for himself and he's always very determined. And once he sets a goal, he doesn't stop until he achieves it.
And he's so good with kids, and I think they all obviously look up to him, and he's like this big teddy bear.
We gotta talk back and forth. Do your homework, go. Make sure you do your homework. And I know he stays up till 12 o'clock studying every day.
The grades are more important to me than basketball, because, you know, basketball could be over tomorrow.
Well, he's got a great work ethic, which comes right from his mom, Mary Ann. You know, she's a phenomenal woman, and you don't have to spend more than 5 minutes with her to realize what a special person she is and how hard she works to make sure Justin and his siblings are in order.
My mother's someone I listen to with all my heart, with everything she say, I'm gonna believe.
His goal is to play beyond college, whether it's overseas or in the NBA. We'll see. But knowing Justin, he might make it.
I just try to do the right thing. That's the best way I feel like to show it, to do the right thing. Don't try to mess up, try to do everything right. Because I've been here for 4 years now, so I know how everything goes. So I just try to make sure I'm on the right page with everything.
You know, Jaymie, he just might be one of those once-in-a-lifetime players you have the privilege of coaching.
It sounds like it, Billy. All right, when we return, we're going to take a look at the women's hockey team and see what it takes to maintain a top 10 national ranking. And there's a new sport in town, and it's creating quite a buzz around the country. and welcome back to Quinnipiac University Bobcats Unleashed. You know, Billy, the women's hockey team has really had a phenomenal season so far.
They sure have made huge strides in the past few years. Let's check in with Bill Schweizer to see what makes this team tick. Bill?
Hi, thanks, Billy and Jaymie. You know, it's been quite a remarkable season for these Lady Bobcats so far. They're headed for their second ECAC playoffs in the last 2 years. And Coach Rick Seely says the key to it is to recruit players that are not only very talented, but players that are leaders on and off the ice.
And basically, we were looking for leaders. We knew to turn this program around, we needed some great leaders for the future. And we think we have a lot of them in the locker room.
We look for certain types of kids that are willing to dedicate themselves and to commit themselves fully to a program. And we're excited about the kids we've been able to bring in so far.
When I had my recruiting visit, I came on campus. The first thing I noticed was the team chemistry. Like, everyone was out here. They knew what they had to be, knew what they had to do, knew what needed to be done, and everyone got along so well. It felt like I belonged here.
We talk a lot about the way we want to play the game, how hard we want to work, the culture of our program.
I think when you start bringing in those kinds of kids, they attract other kids like that. And you have to, really stand by your guns and not let anything slide.
If you're going to be on our team, you're going to know what it means to work hard. And you're either going to do it yourself and work hard yourself, or you're going to be pushed to learn how to work hard.
And all that hard work starts from the top with head coach Rick Seely.
We have a great head coach, first of all, and he's someone who has had a successful history.
Coach Rick and like all the other coaches, like Coach Cass and Coach Harry, they know what they're doing.
They're always pushing to make us better, and no matter if we're winning or losing, they're always really hard on us, which is a good thing.
I think one thing maybe we take for granted sometimes is how hard on us he is, because even when he's hard on us, he cares. I mean, I'd be a little bit more scared if he quit talking to me at all, rather than, he can yell at me all he wants, just don't stop talking to me. So
he shows true passion for the game and all of us together, and it's just great to see, like, when he shows emotion, like, you really deep down, like, feel his emotion, and it's sad when you see him upset, and you're just like, oh my God, we could have done better.
I think he's a fantastic leader, and he has done so much for this program in terms of helping everyone to understand where we want to go and who we want to be, and I don't think there could have been anyone better to create that vision.
Once the vision for the team was created, the next step was continued success in the playoffs.
I think the team right now not only has dreams of winning games, but they have dreams of making postseason tournaments, winning postseason tournaments, and ultimately someday winning the ECAC and going to the NCAA championships.
Well, I think last year, since it was so long coming, making the playoffs, that we almost exhaled when we made the playoffs, and we kind of relaxed in the playoffs. So I think after that experience, the returners, they're not satisfied now. They want to at least take one more step, get to the ECAC semifinals and see what happens.
I definitely think tasting it last year has us all, thirsting for more, and we're definitely, taking baby steps, kind of. We want to reach the same thing we did and host playoffs this year. It's one of our goals, but we're not afraid to see what comes next.
We feel that it's the character of the program, it's the things that we put in place, the fundamentals, that will be a lasting legacy.
No other sport of Quinnipiac can say they're top 10 in the country except women's ice hockey. So I think for that purpose, we're very glad we invested in women's ice hockey, and we're very happy to see the results of the investment.
What we're seeing here is a proven formula for success. Very good coaching, solid recruiting, and very good team chemistry. This program is really headed in the right direction. Billy?
Thanks, Bill. As you know, Jaymie, Quinnipiac is opening up a new medical school on a North Haven campus in 2013.
And one of the most exciting aspects is how it affects the athletic department and the student athletes, particularly, Billy, in the area of recruiting.
Well, recruiting for sure, as it's just another step in helping to enhance the national reputation of the university.
The core values at Quinnipiac just resonate with me in terms of what you want in order to build a medical school.
We will be educating not just doctors, nurses, and physician assistants, as well as physical therapists and occupational therapists, but we'll be educating them together in an interprofessional education way that is truly unique, I'm told, in higher education.
Well, we currently have a shortage of physicians in this country, and it's only going to get worse.
There's such a need, in my mind, for primary care physicians and for a medical school that's geared towards putting out practicing physicians.
And we really think about educating the entire healthcare team. The one person missing from that is the physician. So truly, the addition of a School of Medicine here at Quinnipiac University we see as the next logical step to our commitment to health professions education.
We're already doing an awful lot in health. In fact, up until now, I've always said if you go into a hospital or a major healthcare facility, virtually every one of the healthcare professionals there, with the exception of a doctor, will be a Quinnipiac graduate. But now, at least in September 2013, I'll be able to say everyone you'll find in a hospital healthcare facility could very well have come from Quinnipiac University.
It's the right time to do this. Absolutely the right time.
The new medical school will also provide exciting opportunities for the student athletes and the coaches as well.
And I think, you know, many schools and universities attract great undergraduates who would like to go to their medical school at that university. To have that option for our student athletes to continue to move on, they love that.
It actually enhances our overall recruiting process. Now giving us a full medical school to use to recruit and actually identify players who are pre-med at the Division I level will just take us to another level.
So now, as soon as we hear that this medical school's coming, it's been a new piece to the recruiting for us and what we tell our athletes that we're interested in and what we talk about. So that just put health sciences for me in another place and my athletes in another place.
So there's going to be players that are going to come in the next few years that will do their undergrad, their grad, and all their medical work at Quinnipiac, and will graduate as a doctor, MD from Quinnipiac. That'll be good.
But to have an opportunity for students to be able to follow that dream all the way through and participate in undergraduate curriculum and athletics, and then to move into the graduate arena in a professional program such as medicine or allied health or business or law, it's just a great match for the university.
We're going to not only produce some great professionals in the healthcare area, but we're going to have trained them already as a team working here at the university while they're studying, and they'll be much better, more effective team players when they get out in the real world.
You know, Jaymie, Quinnipiac continues to make great strides under the leadership of President Leahy, his cabinet, and the Board of Trustees.
Yeah, they sure have. All right, when we return, we'll learn about a new sport that is quickly reaching many girls around the country. And we'll check in with Bill Schweitzer, who takes us around campus with some other teams in our newest edition of Bobcat Bits.